skip in a stride like you see a deer that leaps.
Yes.
And doesn't seem to come down forever, you
right.
know?
Right.
I mean, as a human being, we know that physically that may be impossible, but you know what? My dream is that one day it'll be my reality.
Right. Come on.
And then, you know what? Those dreams have begun to get better.
Come on.
The other day, I was dreaming about not just skipping, but being able to defy gravity. Amen. Because planted deep within me is the truth that one day I will mount up like with wings as an eagle, and I will be able to run and not be weary. And I don't know what you think, but wings are meant to fly.
That's right.
Now, they may be some kind of Muskogee, kind of ugly duck that isn't designed to fly with wings. I don't know. But I've even seen those pitiful things fly a little bit. You got to make up your mind whether you're going to be a Muskogee or whatever they're called, or an eagle. That's right.
Amen.
Amen. You've got to make up your mind. If you refer to my first scripture, it said, according to my earnest expectation. What is your expectation? You know, because when I expect things, you know, one of my most prized spiritual dreams was I had mounted up with wings like an eagle. And I really can't remember seeing the wings, to tell you the truth, because it was more of a spiritual thing of soaring. And we were soaring maybe, I don't know, 50-100 feet above the treetops in a formation. And I looked back and I saw my father flying with me.
Oh, <good Lord.
laughs> Woo!
Awesome.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Awesome.
See, my God is an awesome God.
Yes.
Amen.
And He's not done doing what He's going to do, and so I anticipate and I expect more than just a drop out of a bottle.
Amen.
Amen. I expect that God's going to pour out of His Spirit in dramatic fashion the way that He has designed for this generation and for this culture right now. They need to see Christianity like it's never been seen before.
Right.
Amen.
Amen. We need to break back into what is normal for church.
Yeah.
Church in many circles in the world is despised, and for a lot of good reasons.
Amen.
Because of hypocrisy.
Right.
Because of the falsehoods that we embrace and paint God on. Fake people, false victory, broken promises, dishonesty. I could go on with the list. I won't, because I'm persuaded of better things of you.
Come on.
Amen. That of these people, you know, that we can have an arise and shine moment.
Right.
Amen.
I love Isaiah 2. You know, there's, I think, 60:61 says, arise and shine, for the glory of the Lord has risen upon thee. And, you know, and Gentiles will come to the... Amen. Yeah. You know, that's a beautiful Church of God scripture, isn't it? I didn't preach it because of that. The 37th chapter of the Psalms also says to wait. The Bible says, rest in the Lord and wait patiently for Him. Fret not thyself because of him who prospers in his way, because of man who bringeth wicked devices to pass. Cease from anger and forsake wrath, and fret not thyself of any wise to do evil. For evildoers shall be cut off, but those that wait upon the Lord, they shall inherit the earth. For yet a little while, and the wicked shall not be.
Amen.
And yea, thou shalt diligently consider his place, and it shall not be. But the meek shall inherit the earth, and shall delight themselves in the abundance of peace. I have great expectations.
Come on.
Amen. I have great expectations. It's never ending. It's like the 40th chapter of the same psalm. Of the 40th chapter, it says, I waited patiently for the Lord, and He inclined unto me, and He heard my cry, and He brought me up also out of an horrible pit, out of the miry clay, and He set my feet upon a rock, and He established my going. mean.
Come on.
Do you want me to go on?
Come on.
He put a new song in my mouth, even a praise unto God, and many shall see it and fear and shall trust in the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed is the man that maketh the Lord his trust. It just goes on and on.
Amen.
And on.
Yes.
Church, live in expectancy.
Come on.
And in anticipation of the wonderful works of God and what by His Spirit can be accomplished through the body of Christ.
Thank you, Jesus.
And when I say that, I mean you. What can be accomplished through you?
Blessing.
If God made this awesome plan that we could be the body of Christ, wouldn't you want to be joined to that?
Come on.
Amen.
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 If that's God's plan, why do we debase it or look at it as secondary? We call it church, a fellowship, a cell, a home group. The body of Christ. The hands, the eyes, the feet, the heart of love, connected to God in divine fellowship. That's what we are supposed to be. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Would you stand with me this morning? We're going to close with a word of prayer. If you've never accepted the Lord as your Savior, you can do so this morning.